Now, today we'll learn one of the most important thing in exponents. That is, this is very, very valuable for your upcoming classes also. So, please concentrate on this session of video, okay? Now, these are called laws of exponents, which will be very, very helpful for your next exercise and for your higher classes also. Now, laws of exponents. Now, as we know that how to say this a to the power n, isn't it? A to the power n. Now this a is called base and the powers are, and n is called power. Okay, so this is the basic idea that you need to have before you understand all the laws of exponents. Okay, the first law is that when you see a to the power n and a to the power m, you see the both the terms are carrying the same base. Both the term are carrying the same base and they have different powers. And what is there in between these two terms? It is into sign. So always remember, when the base are same, then in case of multiplication, we always add the powers. Okay, example, 2 to the power 3 into 2 to the power 5. Suppose it is like this. So as because you see the base are same, what is the base? 2. So how to write this? What is the answer of this? So we know that in case of multiplication, what to do? We will add the powers, isn't it? So answer would be 2 to the power 8. So it's as simple as this. Okay, now let's move on to next law. Next law is, when the base are same, then in case of division, we subtract the powers. Okay, now example is what? Suppose 3 to the power 6 divided by 3 to the power 2. So what we'll do, now we see that the base are same, division sign is there in between them, so we have to subtract the powers. So the answer would be 3 to the power 4. Okay, so this is the second law. Now what is the third law? Third law is, suppose if any base is carrying already one power, and if you see another power is added, n to the power m, a to the power n to the power m. So what is the, what you have to do now? You have to multiply the powers, n into m, n into m. Okay, now example is 3 to the power 2 to the power 3. Now what you have to do? 3, 2 into 3, isn't it? So answer would be 3 to the power 6, isn't it? Now I hope you have understood all these things. Please do write all the things in your copy. Okay, now the next law is, now next law is, if you see any base which is carrying power as 0, any base, okay, then the answer would be always 1. That is, example, 2 to the power 0 will be considered as 1. Suppose 2 by 3 is 2 to the power 0 will be considered as 1. Okay, understood. So the law says that any base which carries a power as 0, the answer would be always 1. Okay, now let's move on to the next law. The next law is, see, it's very interesting. Now, what you see here, you see the base are different now. This term is carrying base as A and this term is carrying base as B. Now, base are different, but the powers are same, isn't it? Now, in this case, what you have to do? You have to just multiply the power and make the powers as common. Example what? Suppose 2 to the power 3 and 5 to the power 3. Okay. So, what will the answer? You have to multiply the base. That is 2 into 5 and 3. That is, the answer would be 10 to the power 3. Understood? Now, let's move on to another very, very important law. That is, suppose if any base is carrying minus power as in minus form, so what you will do? So not minus 1, minus n. Okay, now a is a base. A means what? A by 1, isn't it? If you write 2, what is the meaning of 2? 2 by 1, isn't it? So what is a is means a by 1. So this particular base is carrying minus n. Now to make this power a positive one, what we have to do? We have to just reciprocal the value. That is 1 upon a. This is the funda. Okay, that is example 2 to the power minus 3. Okay, 2 to the power minus 3. How to do this? What is the meaning of 2? 2 by 1. Now, this is carrying as minus 3. Okay, so how to make this 3 as a positive? So, what we'll do is 1 by 2. The reciprocal of 2 by 1 is what? 1 by 2 to the power 3. So, answer would be 1 by 2 cube. Because 1 cube is 1 only. Okay, so answer you can write as 1 by 8. I hope every laws you have understood. These are very, very important law, students. Okay, so today you just make yourself accustomed with all those laws. Okay, then from Monday onwards, we'll start exercise 13.2. Okay, thank you and take care, all of you.